So let's talk about the find function in MATLAB. The find function is super important. So let's say that like I'm on a dating website and, you know, because I totally went into math to meet boys, I'm going to look for, I don't know, I've got my choice of all the math guys I could possibly ever want. So I'm going to start looking at them by age. So I've got like this database of guys, and because I'm socially awkward, I'm not actually going to talk to them. I'm just going to run like data analysis on it and then not actually talk to them in real life because I'll give up eventually, but that's okay. So I'm going to have ages for people, and they've all submitted to my something profile, and there are all these kinds of ages, and I'm like, I don't know. And then there's like that. Okay. So there's a divided by 2 plus 7 rule, which is kind of fun. It has nothing to do with the conversation, but it's always a great idea to know if you should be dating someone. So if you're 30, you divide your age by 2 and then you add 7, which I guess I could do by hand, but I have MATLAB right here, so I'll do it with MATLAB. So if you're 30, the youngest person you can date is 22. It actually works really well because if you're 14, the youngest person you can date is 14. And it basically minimizes your dating age, but you're like, but wait, what if you're 7? Well, then you can date someone who's 10, but someone who's 10 can't date you. So anyway, back to this doesn't have anything to do with anything land. Basically what I could do is I could do a search function. I'm like, I want to find people who are over 21 and less than 50. I don't know why. No. Okay. We'll go over 21 and less than 50. So I can say these are options. I'm going to call my options are people who are ages that are, well, let's just start with over 21, 21 and up. So I can say I want to find the ages that are greater than or equal to 21. All right. So I'm going to run this, and there we go. So it's telling me that my options are persons 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So that's what those 2 through 6 and 7 mean. That's actually telling me that those are the index numbers of the people that are available. So if I was going to be a little bit more picky and I'm like, no, they have to be 25, that's going to knock off the 21-year-old. And I could say, well, no, no, no. I don't care that much that they're 21. I just want them to be less than, you know, I don't know, 80. Then that gives me all the options but 4. So I can do 1, 2, 3, but not 4. And then I could do 5, 6, and 7. So, you can actually combine these with ands and ors. So if I wanted to say this guy's got to be at least 21, but younger than 50. Okay, so you need to think about the way that this wording is. So if I say that they have to be at least 21, that means that they can be 21, because at least 21 means they can be 21. So they need to be greater than or equal to 21. But less than 50. And you have to think, well, does that mean that it's an and or it's an or? Like, is it okay as long as they're over 21 or at least 21 or less than 50? And the answer is, well, no, because if they're over 21 or less than 50, then I could say, well, let me go ahead and say this. So if I say 21 and ages is less than 50. So, if I put an or in there, then that means that if it meets either condition, it's good. So like a 12-year-old is technically less than 50, so that would meet the requirements. Or a 985-year-old is greater than or equal to 21, so that would meet the requirement. But I want to meet both requirements, so they have to be at least 21, but also younger than 50. So I can do that. I can combine that with a little and sign, and now that's going to say, okay, your options are 2, 3, and 7. So I have the option of the 38, the 28, and the 21. But you know, of course, oh my God, we have to make sure that they make enough money. So we're gonna look at how much money they make. So I don't know how much, we'll pretend these are in tens of thousands of dollars. So this guy makes, you know, 12 and 80 and 19 and I don't know, 39. You can hardly live on that these days. Can't buy a decent car for less than 50 grand. 75, I have no idea what I'm talking about. I drive a Honda Element. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I made 7 of those, so I need 7 of these. And the 57-year-old makes, you know, 44, and the 21-year-old makes, you know, I don't know. He's super smart, so he makes that much money. Okay, so that's how much money they make. So now see if you can write code to find the folks who make at least, I don't know, 50K a year. That's gonna really limit my options, but you know, 50K a year. So see if you can just write the code that's going to find the people who make at least enough money, you know, because that's totally the way I am. So now my money options. So again, pause the video, see if you can make that thing work. Money. So not money, find. I want to find where the money is at least 50K a year. So I said I was writing all those in terms of thousands. So I can say, okay, so my options there are 2, 5, and 7. They make plenty of money. So now here's the fun part. Now you want to write a statement to find who meets both the age and money requirement. Does that make sense? Because like this is really, really important. Or how about this? I could say, well, let's do that one first. So see if you can write code that says that they're going to meet both the age and the money requirements. Do-do-do-do-do. So pause the video, blah, 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 blah. People, shadow people, choices. So I can actually combine multiple kinds of things. So I can combine the age. I can do multiple things on age, and I can also do things on money. So I can say, here's your ages, and you have to make at least 50. Okay, so now this tells me I can only choose suitors number 2 and 7. So he's 38 and makes 80,000, and he's 21 and makes 99,000. So it's perfect. So think about, what if I decide that they can meet age requirements, or they make at least, 75,000 a year? Because, who cares how old you are if you make a lot of money? Because, I'm sorry, I sound like a terrible person. I just tired and writing code and recording videos in the middle of the night because it's like almost 8:30. Okay, so see if you can write code that will say, I either want you to meet my age requirements or I want you to make a ton of money, because, that's how this works. So more shadow choices. So I want to find, so this is still an and statement. So I still want to have, you have to meet both of these requirements, and this is where the next word comes in, or I want you to meet this requirement. Okay, so if you remember your precedent, so I'm going to write this over here. Remember precedent. The and is done first, the or is done second. So you have to meet both of these at the same time, or you could meet this one. So it's not that you don't do the or first and then the and. You have to do both of the ands and then you do the or. And hopefully that kind of makes sense. So let's run that. And now that gives me a lot more options, because this is totally real. So let me suppress these so that I can see what I'm doing. There we go. So if I'm looking to someone who is between 21 and 50, so if I only care about that, I can say, okay, you're between, oh, I totally lost my options. There. So I'm looking for someone who's between 21 and 50 so that he doesn't qualify. He does. So that's number 2, qualifies on age alone. Qualifies 3, qualifies on age. And 7, qualifies on age alone. But then if I also say, well, I'm going to be a little bit open-minded, right? So if you make at least $75,000 a year, that also, so 2 is already in there. So it's important to notice that we don't actually list 2 twice. We just list him one time. So he qualifies both. He's no good, no good, totally fine. That's now number 5. So 5 gets in there, and 9 or 7 was already in there as well. So you can do all kinds of stuff by combining greater thans and less thans and ors and ands and really pull any kind of data that you're looking for. So what can you do with this data? Well, let's say that I had the names of these people. That's kind of weird. I don't know. Instead of having names, let's just have like ID numbers, phone numbers. I don't know. These are their really unique phone numbers. In fact, they're kind of the same. How about and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we could say that these are their names, and I guess we live in a robot world now where we make dating choices based on queries and everybody has a robot name. So these are all their robot names. So If I now know which suitors I'm going to choose, I can ask for the names at these particular locations. And then whenever I run it, it will just give me the names of those people who meet those requirements. So you'll say, okay, you can date robot 334, robot 239, or robot 209, or robot 59. So I can actually get data. I can actually get more specific data. So if I had a reference and if I had actually names, I don't want to do names because it's, you know, weird. So I could do something like that. There's a couple of more things I can also do that are, you know, just, you know, for whatever reason. I'll go ahead and suppress these so you can see back to what I'm doing. Oh, it's because I didn't start with CLC. Okay, so I have my ages and I have the money. Now, I could actually ask MATLAB, are all of the people, suitor people, are they all 18 and up? Because if they're not, that's kind of creepy. So I can say, are all of them greater than or equal to 18? And the answer comes back as yes. And I could say, do all of them make at least, $25,000? And it comes back and it says no. So if it's going to be all, that's literally saying, do all of them meet this requirement? Similar to all, we actually have something called any. Are there any of them who are over 18? And it's going to say, well, yes, ages, sorry. Are there any of them who are over 18? And it's like, yes, because you, all of them are. So I could say, well, are any of them, you know, over, you know, 78? And it'll say, yes, lucky you. Okay, so there are perfectly lovely 78-year-olds. Okay, any ages. Are there any, not sorry, any, is there anybody who makes more money than 25,000? Because it's, I asked that, does everybody makes 25? And it was like, no. So I can say, well, does anybody make 25? And it can say yes. So this is kind of cool. I'm using any and all to just kind of query the entire data at once. So I can say, does anybody in this data set make at least $75,000? And then it'll say yes. And I'm like, oh, okay, well then this is actually, you know, worth doing code. So it's just really kind of cool. You can use, so I can say, do any of the, I wonder if this works. Yes, do any of them. And I wonder if said all. So there aren't any who are greater than, that make more than that and are, actually, I don't know what that's doing. Because I'm asking, are all of them? Are all of them over 70, make over 75,000 and all at least 18? And I say, do all of them make at least $5? And the answer is yes. So I can actually combine those even more than I've used or thought about doing in the past. So any, all, find, these are all fantastic little function-y code thingies that you can use in MATLAB and get all kinds of information.